I'm going to be cleaning surgical instruments immediately after use, so I'm going to be cleaning instruments from a general small spay pack that was just used. Right now I have them soaking in some cool water to keep any blood or tissues or organic debris from drying on them. So while those are soaking in some cold water, I'm going to make some detergent water. So we have some instrument cleaning tablets. It is a neutral pH, and they're just little tablets that dissolve in water to create the cleaning solution. So according to the manufacturer instructions, one tablet per 2 quarts of water. So since I'm only cleaning one instrument pack, that should be plenty enough. So I have some markings in my sink. I'm gonna go ahead and start filling that up with water. And I'm gonna go ahead and just open my little pouch. I got a nice little size tablet. I'm just gonna drop it in the water and it's going to immediately dissolve. I'm just gonna wait for that to fill up. Kind of mix it around a little bit to make it dissolve a little bit quicker. Alright, once we have 2 quarts of water, I'm gonna go ahead and turn that off. Mix around my solution. My tablet has already completely dissolved, so my detergent water is ready for use. So next I'm going to just take each of my instruments and I'm going to just gently put them in the detergent water. I just want to make sure that all of my instruments are open, all of the ratchets are open, just so that the detergent water can get nice down deep into all of the grooves and all of the serrations of the instrument. I just want to be careful reaching into here. My back house towel clamps are really sharp, so I just want to make sure not to stab myself with those. And I have my thumb forceps. With my Kelly hemostats. Instruments have been placed into my detergent water. I'm going to go ahead and start manually scrubbing them. So I don't want to use anything too harsh because my instruments are incredibly delicate. So I do have a soft bristled toothbrush that I'm going to use. And then after I'm done, I'm going to place them into my ultrasonic cleaner. With my ultrasonic cleaner, we use a non-ionic, non-ammoniated, phosphate-free, neutral pH ultrasonic cleaning solution. And this is changed out every morning that it is used. So that has been made fresh this morning. So my instruments are going into clean solution. So you can see my cleaner right here. All right. So I'm gonna go ahead and start. All right, so with my instruments, I just want to make sure this is my Olsen-Hagar needle driver. I just want to very gently go in the direction of the serrations on both sides. Blood and organic debris likes to go in there. And I want to make sure that I'm going in a to and fro motion. And then I want to move down to the box locks and just go in the direction of the grain. And then I'm also going to clean the shaft of the instrument in a to and fro motion, very gently. And then I want to get in the grooves of the ratchet on both sides, clean my handles. And then I want to make sure that my ratchet is open, and I'm just going to gently place it into my ultrasonic cleaner. And then I have my back house towel clamps. I'm going to do a to and fro motion in the direction of the grain of the instrument at the tips. And then I'm going to clean the box locks, also staying in the direction of the grain, down to the shafts and then the handles. I also want to get in the grooves of the ratchet as well. Right. And we have four back house towel clamps in this pack, so I'm just going to do the same thing with all of those. touch it real good, all those little grooves. I've got all of my towel clamps, so I'm going to move on to my curved nuts and balm dissecting scissors. These I want to go in the direction of the grain of the instrument. I'm going to go in that to and fro motion. Make sure I open it nice and wide because blood and debris likes to kind of hang out in there as well. I'm going to follow the same pattern, going with the grain of the instrument and opening it wide enough to get good in there. And then the rings. And then we have 6 pairs of Kelly hemostatic forceps. These all have a line of serrations on the side, so I just want to make sure that I go in the direction of the serrations in a to and fro motion on both sides. Blood likes to collect up in there. And I'm going to move down to a straight area. I'm going to go in the direction of the grain. Clean up the box locks on both sides. Get to the shaft. Paying special attention to the ratchet, make sure that I get all of those little grooves in there. I'm going to repeat that same process with each of my Kelly hemostats. Direction of the serrations with the grain in a to and fro motion. Paying special attention to the ratchet and all those little grooves and the rings. Two more sets of my Kellys. One more. Ratchet pretty good. And then we have our Atlas tissue forceps. These have little hooks on the end. I'll make sure to go in the direction of those. And then move down. Go in the direction of the grain. Just to make sure I get any blood that's hanging out in there out of the way. A snook ovariohysterectomy hook, also referred to as just a spay hook. This one I want to make sure to go in the direction of the grain. I'm going to get the entire piece here all the way down to the end on both sides. And I also want to do the same thing with the actual hook very well, going in the direction of the grain. And then I have my rat tooth thumb forceps. They have little divots on the side, so I want to make sure to get in those real well in a to and fro motion. And then I want to just go with the grain of the instrument. Make sure I get it good on the inside. And then also on the outside, it has some little serrations here. So I'm going to go in the direction of those serrations. And then with the grain of the instrument for the rest. And then I have my Addison Brown thumb forceps. They have some little serrations here. I want to pay very close attention to those, just because those can collect blood and tissue as well. Get in there. Get little serrations on the outside. And then go with the grain of the instrument. And last but not least, I have a number three scalpel handle. I'm going to get the little serrations on the outside. I'm going to go with the grain of the instrument all the way down in a to and fro motion. Make sure to get the little tip too. Alright, so according to manufacturer instructions, they recommend setting this ultrasonic cleaner for 15 minutes. So I'm going to set that for 15 minutes, and I'm going to drain my detergent water and rinse out the sink while that's running. So that's 15 minutes. Alright, we'll check back in 15 minutes when we are ready to take those out of the ultrasonic cleaner. The ultrasonic cleaner ran for 15 minutes and it is now finished, so my instruments are completed. That was kind of a secondary cleaning just to make sure that all of the blood, tissue, organic debris is removed after the scrubbing. The ultrasonic cleaner uses sound waves to give gentle vibrations to pull off any other dirt that I may have missed in the scrubbing. So I have a little basket in here. I'm just going to gently remove it. I'm going to put it in the sink here. Now I'm going to thoroughly rinse each instrument and I'm going to inspect them just to make sure that they are clean, working properly, make sure that my scissors close appropriately, that all of my ratchets close and open the way that they're supposed to, and then they're going to go into a tub of instrument milk. On top, I have my Rep2 thumb forceps. I'm just going to rinse those, get all of the detergent off. I'm just going to make sure they close the way they're supposed to and that they're nice and clean. And I'm going to drop them into my instrument milk. And I have my Alice tissue thumb forceps. I'm going to make sure that those close, that they open appropriately. They're clean, there's no blood left in the box blocks or anywhere. I have my ovariohysterectomy stay hook. Nice and clean. And when I'm placing my instruments in my instrument milk, I'm making sure that all of the ratchets are in an open position just so that the instrument milk can reach around all of the instrument. And the instrument milk is lubricating my instruments just to make sure that's going to keep them opening properly, and it's also conditioning the metal to keep them in good working order. Keep them from breaking soon or rusting or anything like that. Some more Kelly hemostat. Bonsai sectioning scissors. with these especially, I want to make sure they close all the way and that the tip doesn't kind of stay apart a little bit. I'm just going to keep them nice and open when I put them in the instrument milk. Same thing with my mayo dissecting scissors. Needle holders. I just want to make sure especially that this closes all the way, the ratchet locks the way that it is supposed to, and that my tip comes close enough. And I want to look in here. The part that holds the needle tends to want to break sooner on this instrument, but that's coming together nicely. My ratchet closes, it opens easily. Then I'm going to open that and put that in my instrument milk. And then last, I have my scalpel blade handle. Rinse that off, make sure there's no blood or anything dried on there. Alright, so according to the manufacturer of the instrument milk, these instruments should sit in here for 5 to 10 minutes. So I'm going to let these sit for 10 minutes to get nice and conditioned, and then I'm going to take them out and set them out to dry. Once my instruments have been appropriately sitting in the instrument mill for about 10 minutes, I'm going to set them out to dry. So instruments do not need to be rinsed after sitting in the milk. So I'm just going to carefully take one by one and kind of just give it a good little shake here. And I'm going to lay them on a surgical towel. I want to use this towel because there's no extra lint or pet hair or anything on them, as they've been washed with only surgical laundry. And I'm just going to lay all of my instruments down on the table. I'm gonna make sure I leave them down nice and open so that they can air dry and all of my box locks and ratchets and everything are open. So I'm gonna give it a little shake. And none of my instruments were in need of any repair. If they were, I would have set them aside for to send them to the manufacturer according to hospital policy. I want to be gentle when I'm tapping them out, just because my instruments are delicate and I don't want to cause any damage to them after they've already been inspected and they are about to be ready for packing for sterilization. as all of my instruments. So my instruments have all been set out to dry. They have been appropriately cleaned, scrubbed, put through the ultrasonic cleaner, rinsed, inspected, and set in instrument milk. And now I'm going to leave them out to air dry. And then we will be ready to go ahead and pack these and get them ready for sterilization.